beautiful astrology soulmates, and welcome to your weekly horoscope for the week of August 10th, where as we travel this week, you guys, it's really interesting because there are these blasts of just firepower level energy that come at us, and it is really up to our discretion to pick where that is going to kind of propel and motivate us to. We're going to have Mercury and Uranus starting out at the beginning of the week, coming into a square with one another, and this is an action-packed, very electric, very, ugh, I should do something. Ugh, I should take this risk kind of energy, but you need to just be mindful of where you're putting your risk. Where are you going to take that adventure, right? It's a great week, but there are definitely a couple things to consider as we travel this week. Now, before we get into the weekly horoscope, this week on the Eat and Greets, we are welcoming over Miss Kathy Rose will be here. Kay Taylor will be here this week as well. So I hope that you catch those Eat and Greets. One will be on Monday, one will be on Wednesday. And these women are just fantastic. If you have not met them yet in the astrology world or in the astrology community, I'm telling you, you are missing out. These women are phenomenal. Not to mention that Kathy Rose brings forward some of the teachings of Noel Till. And if you don't know anything about Noel either, I really am going to put a link in the description box because you've got to know the brilliance that this man added to this community. So just beautiful Eat and Greets this week. I can't wait to welcome you, sit with you, and teach and learn with you as well this week. All right, let's talk about what's happening in the cosmos. So right as we're coming into the week, on the 10th, we're going to see Mercury, who's over in the energy of Leo, coming into a square with Uranus, who's in the energy of Taurus. Now, they're going to square up at 11 degrees, respectively, at both of these signs. So grab your chart. Check out where 11 degrees is hitting for you. Is it hitting a personal planet, maybe a point in your chart? Within about 5 degrees, you may feel that particular planet or house being swept up in this energy. Now, Mercury and Uranus coming together, I'm going to tell you, because it's a square, and that square is the 911, and it says, we have to do something to get out of this tension, you maybe will really want to take a risk that day. You're like, oh, I got to do it. I got to do it now. I got to push, right? And a risk is fine, but you just want to be very, very clear on what you're doing with that risk, because this isn't the best energy to actually take it. This is a great energy to have a risk or have a need to be or see something or communicate something from a different perspective, but it's not necessarily the best day to do it. Now, I will tell you, I honestly believe as well, under the energy or in the spaces of social media, we may see some really big, bold statements being made. And it, as a person, if you've got some big things to say as well, today when you say them, make sure you can stand behind them, because these are the kind of days that come back and bite you in the butt on the other side, okay? So this is a brilliantly electric energy. It is so delicious for helping you really see something from a different perspective or stimulating you into a new thought process that you just couldn't quite get your head around. That is what it is so great for. It is not the best for being big, bad, bold, and taking that huge risk on this particular day. But you do you. You know, I always support that. And I absolutely don't believe in life that you can screw this thing up. Everything's going to have your next lesson behind it. So do you, okay? As we continue on through the week, we get to Thursday and we see another bump in energy. And it can be a day that I think you maybe you want to push and you want to rush forward here as well. And Mars is going to come into a rough square with Pluto. Now, we've got Mars who's over in Aries and we've got Pluto who's in Capricorn. So as these two square up with each other, it'll be at 23 degrees. Okay, so check that out in your chart. But as these two square together, this is a little bit of a battle, right? Mars is like, I'm ready to do things. And even though he's in shadow time and slowed down, he wants to do. This is our doing energy. And Pluto says, I'm trying to evolve. I am down here in the icky stickies trying to transform something. And so as these two come together, they are bringing forward challenge. They are bringing forward confrontation, which these words are not bad words. I want to be clear on that. They don't have to have negative connotation, but they are going to come up. It can also bring a little bit of aggression and assertion in order to meet this challenge, meet this power struggle, meet this change. So what I can tell you, Those two come together, and sometimes we see violence in the air. We see somebody, you're threatening someone, or you're even standing in a way that is threatening to someone, or vice versa. Or what you feel like is this particular person, place, thing, idea has come to your table and it threatens your identity, your way of life, something in your structure. What I can tell you is watch it, be with it, be challenged, because it is absolutely trying to show you something, and don't push it to the edge of that violence. It is just unnecessary. Unless, of course, it is self-defense, then you have to do you. Now, as we continue on through the week, we're going to see Uranus on Saturday on the 15th stepping into his retrograde. Now, Uranus is going to start his retrograde at 11 degrees of Taurus, and as he comes out in 2021, it'll be at 7 degrees of Taurus. Uranus is not back there making all kinds of degree progress. He's very slow moving, and he's electric in the energy of Taurus right now, so we better be really grateful for that, because Uranus in Taurus is not comfortable, and he's like shaking and waking up a mountain. So we better be grateful that he doesn't just whip around here and like fix it all, you know? So as he goes retrograde, though, for the rest of the year, we're going to review, re-edit, revise, reconsider. For the next 5 months, you're going to look at the Taurus areas of your life. This is a time to look back over. Where do you need to innovate? What you've been doing in your grounded, maybe fixed, maybe stuck routine kind of areas of your life. Uranus in a retrograde is just as surprising as he is going forward. You could have surprises from the past. You could have surprise reactions from the past. You could have surprise things that maybe you were working on something earlier in the year and you tried to innovate a little bit and you're not sure if you quite got it. Uranus is going to help you see if you did and also bring some of that value forward. But what I can tell you with a Uranus retrograde is still expect the unexpected, but this time it'll come forward from the past. As we rumble and we shake a mountain, sometimes we unearth some things that now at this point in our lives, as we're ready, we have the tools, we have the skills, we have the support, we have the resources. Now we're ready to deal with them. Now we're ready to bring that project forward. But whatever it is, Uranus is also going to be back here and show you something that says, you got to work on this, because if you don't, we won't have freedom. We won't have financial freedom. We won't have emotional freedom. Uranus in this retrograde is about your freedom, okay? As we get to the 16th of the week, and we're ending it here on Sunday, we're going to see the Sun and Mars come into a trine. Now, a trine is a nice triangular, in its symbol anyways, pocket of opportunity. So it creates some ease here. This is a completely different energy than we see earlier in the week, right? So here, it's like you get to be active because the Sun is in Leo, Mars is in Aries. This is fire energy loading up, and you're ready to go do something. You're ready to put your back into a little something. And this is a nice harmonious aspect. These fire buddies are working together, but they do work differently, right? Aries is like, let's go do it. And Leo's like, yep, let's go do it. And let's go do it first. Let's be at the front. Let's show who we are. Let's show what I've got to offer. But it's a beautiful energy. It's a boost of energy to get things done. Not to mention, what I do love about some fire energy is it brings this sense of self-confidence. It brings some heat to the blood that makes us move and dance and create in ways that we don't when we're so heavy in other energies. So the end of the week, I think, makes all of the rest of it worth it. Not that the journey's not completely worth it, but you know, a little fire at the end of the week is really, really nice. So I hope you guys have a brilliant week. Please keep me posted on what's happening for you this week. And also, did you come and attend the summit, the astrology summit for power and purpose? And did you like it? What did you think? Would you like to have something like that around here? Let me know in the comment section down below if that's something you were thinking about, you saw, you have any experience about, okay? All right, you guys, I'll see you in the eat and greets this week and all around the channel as well. I love you guys. Bye, everybody.